In the User Definable section of the master unit, there are 12 hardware function keys that can be assigned custom commands in Nuendo. In addition to that, if you activate that section, there are an additional 24 touchscreen buttons that are also user definable. There are 4 banks of these. In order to assign a custom command to either the button or one of the touchscreen functions, you access the menu here. Now let's take a look at the first user-defined hardware button. We can pick a category and choose one of those functions, and now that has been mapped to that particular key. So once you've defined a series of function keys and also touchscreen buttons, it is also possible to exchange 12 at a time between the touchscreen and the hardware keys itself. So for example, if I wanted these 12 function keys now to be mapped to the hardware keys on the Surface, I simply press this button. And in the touchscreen, you'll see now which function keys are mapped to the hardware buttons on the control surface. Any one of the 4 banks can be mapped to the hardware buttons, 12 buttons at a time. If a function button appears grayed out on the touchscreen, it indicates that that function is not available because you're in a different menu or perhaps on a different page. When that function does become available, it becomes highlighted on the screen and you can use it. In addition to that, if you access the configuration menu, you can make functions that are repeatable. In other words, if you hold the button down, that function will repeat over and over again. For example, to add multiple audio tracks. There are an additional 3 user-definable function buttons on the fader unit. In order to configure these, you need to go to the Devices menu and select Nuage Fader Setup. And here, you have the configurations for both fader units right here. If you have commonly used functions always mapped to the same key, it's also possible to relabel that button. You can pull the cap off the button like this and relabel it as you desire.